Dragons. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Tina, and today I'm going to do Get Ready With Me. We're going to talk about some current updates and some things I'm thinking about social media. Let's go. I already have down all my primers and stuff because it takes a while for that to soak in. Sunscreen, all those things are all done. So I have some real thoughts on what's been going on with social media lately and the attitude people have about trolls and stalkers and just the awful side of social media. You know, when I started my channel, I knew about these people. I knew that this happened. I figured I'd get, you know, people saying you're ugly, you're fat, and I've definitely gotten that. But I didn't expect anything crazy because in my mind, that's basically just for people who have much bigger presence than I do, who are famous. You know, I knew it could happen to anybody, but it just, I didn't seem as being worthy. You know, having a stalker is something famous people have. It's what happens when the guy you're dated turns out to be a total asshole and abusive and all that. So at this point in my life, I pretty much consider myself, you know, not really at risk for such a thing. I also gave the same advice to people that people have said forever about dealing with trolls and all that. It's just ignore them, they'll go away. Some people say leave their comments on your channel because it's like more engagement and all that. I'd say for the first while, I pretty much agreed with that advice. Now I can unequivocally say I do not. One of the things that's driving me bonkers is that we apparently blame the people who have the channel who are getting harassed, who feel harassed and emotionally abused. You know, it's their fault because they're not strong enough. What bullshit is that? That is victim blaming and gaslighting and just all sorts of things none of us want to do, and we just don't think of it that way because what happens when you have a YouTube channel? No, it's not normal and it's not okay. And we need to stop saying it is and start dealing with it. Now, I've kind of approached this a little bit before. People always kind of give you the response of, yeah, but. Well, you're right. We shouldn't blame the people being harassed. But at the same time, we still do. You know, it's still your fault because you're just not strong enough to deal with it. And if you're not strong enough to deal with it, then you shouldn't have a YouTube channel. How crazy is that? If you're not emotionally strong enough to be abused, then you shouldn't do something. What? You get this from both men and women, but it's much more common from men. I think that's just the way men tend to be raised in this world, is you have to be strong enough for everything. And I think it's bullshit because there are channels out there who do amazing things. Channels that deal with mental health issues and stuff like that. And depression, and I know I have family, very close family, that has severe depression, clinical depression. These people do not need somebody saying kill yourself. And I know for a fact that these people definitely go after those channels because in their mind, sick little minds, they're having the most effect and getting the most out of it, I guess. And that is a mental problem. It's absolutely a mental issue. I suspect it varies from person to person as to why they do this. We can't just keep ignoring it. At least in the United States, we love to ignore stuff because it's expensive and people don't know how to deal with it. They don't know what to do. It's not like treating an arm broken or a leg. So instead we blame the people with the disease. And that's bullshit. We have got to stop doing that and start actually confronting this issue. We can't keep blaming the people who are having it happen to them. We actually need to deal with it. Like I said, I've gotten some really nasty comments. And the ones that really bothered me, they really chased me away from my channel for a bit. I still posted, but it definitely wasn't the type of content or with the enthusiasm and happiness that I normally had had. And I stopped doing pretty much anything to help my channel grow. I just kept posting because I like posting and I like creating videos, but I didn't like the actual experience I was getting. I didn't know how to deal with it because I was just reading other people's posts about the things that were going on.
I knew that other people, how they were being treated for having similar issues to mine.
I did get sympathy for what people would say when it was truly, truly awful. You know, oh my gosh, nobody should ever say that. Oh my gosh, that's terrible. Whatever. But the advice is still the same. Ignore it. It'll go away. Nobody ever actually said, hey, what do we do about this issue? And I think we're creating our own environment on YouTube. YouTube responds to the things we say. And because we don't speak up and say, hey, we need to deal with the bullying issue enough. Like, they have some, but not nearly as much as if there was a total outcry about it. If that happened, I think you'd see the trolling and all this stuff come down. But instead, because we've just ignored it, basically we've said it's okay. So I'm doing like pink lemonade look. Pink on the outside and yellow is going in. I'm going to use my BH Cosmetics Festival Weekend Festival palette, the Lime Crime Pocket Candy in Pink Lemonade, and then Lime Crime Birthday palette and the Anastasia Alisa Edwards palette. I'm taking Dibby, which is this pink here, and I'm just going to start blending that into my outer corner. I know that people are going, well, there's nothing we can really do about this. We can't make it stop. You can't make people stop being mean. You're right, you can't. You can't physically stop them, but you can socially make it more socially unacceptable. And that's the thing that we haven't done. And it just seems like it's getting worse, that we're just like okay with this bullshit. That's not okay. We're a better society than that. We need to start being supportive of the people being bullied and harassed and being abused because they dare to have a hobby that's YouTube or social media. And that's the other thing, we don't value it. We see social media as though it has no value. So I'm taking Eclectic and I'm just gonna blend around the top of that. I know this because I know my own experience and how it went and how I felt. Now, not everybody's gonna have the same feelings I do or whatever, I'm not claiming that. We know it has an effect on people because people do speak out about it. But we say, ignore it, it'll go away. It doesn't go away. Okay, so I'm taking the Alisa Edwards palette and taking that yellow on fluffy kind of packing brush, and I'm just gonna bring that into the center and up and blend it into that pink a little bit. So how do we deal with this? One thing I'm gonna start doing is when I see it happening on somebody else's channel, I'm not gonna ignore it. And I know that's gonna invite some nasty comments on my channel. But if I can help somebody else who's dealing with that, and I'm not gonna be mean to the person posting trolling, I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna say, hey, what you're doing isn't okay and you really should seek help for this. And then into my inner corner, I'm gonna start speaking up. I have had basically a stalker on my channel for quite some time. I pretty much just tried to ignore it. I tried several things and I would talk to people about it and I'd basically be getting one of the responses I've said, you know, it would be any one of those. Oh, I'm so sorry. To, well, if you can't handle it, you shouldn't have a YouTube channel, which is bullshit. I'm gonna take Candles out of the birthday palette, and I'm just popping that right in the center of that yellow. If you follow me on Facebook and stuff, you know that my Instagram got hacked. Okay, so I'm taking my Pretty Vulgar blush. I just assumed that whoever did that was like trying to do what people do when they do things like that. I thought they were trying to steal something or something. I didn't think they were targeting me specifically, exactly. You know, Instagram gets hacked, it happens. So honestly, when it first happened, I just, damn it, this sucks. How do I get my channel back? I'm gonna take Texas Made out of here, and on a small brush, just bring that around the corner. And now I'm gonna take Euphoria on a really tiny brush, bring that all the way under. I just assumed, you know, whatever. They got my account. It took me a bit to get them out. I didn't think much of it other than that, which was annoying. And I went on with my day. They didn't hack into my account, try to steal my credit card information and go, which I guess should have been my clue that this wasn't normal. They stayed logged into it. This is the peach blur, setting everything with it. They were logged into it and they would change my information, my name, my email address. They'd put in their email address. When I figured out how to get them out of my account, I sent them an email saying, you know, basically, what the hell is wrong with you? you need to get a life and stop trying to steal from people. Not thinking too much of it. The Instagram email that I use is almost entirely for my YouTube channel. I get ads for makeup and stuff like that. I don't get much in the way of anything serious. I noticed all of a sudden I wasn't getting any emails. And I was like, what the hell? Turns out they hacked into my email because I had stupidly given it to them, then forwarded it all to themselves. Well, then they did something just insane. I assume they thought that I was the one who worked for the Catholic Church, which I do not. I'm not Catholic. But both my kids were working for the Catholic Church in a summer camp. And this is the chrome pot in gold. And they started sending them some emails, apparently. My oldest son was fired. Now, we're pretty sure because he was fired because of what they were sending them. Because just the way the whole thing went down. It was weird. He was fired for technicality. And it was like, what? And on the last day, he was supposed to work at that. It didn't make any sense to us. And we were really confused at the time. Well, now, looking back, it's pretty obvious that they had started sending them stuff. Who knows what? I can't imagine anything nice. And it was just bad. Now, I don't know why somebody would do that. It just sick and demented. Mean. My youngest son has Asperger's. He was also working there in the kitchen. But the whole situation was just so screwed up. And I had to go through and like, change all passwords because they also tried to get into my Facebook account. I had everything like double password protected where you have to do two-step verification. It's just annoying, but saved my butt on this occasion. I didn't do anything to deserve any of that. And I had thought, because I'm just me, that nobody would do something like this to me, because why bother? Yeah, that's not how it works. These people don't care about things like that. So this is the Tarte Festival lipstick. I repurchased it. Somebody had stole it from me. And I'm just going to take this Tarte bronzer. It's like a pink bronzer, blushy bronzer. And I'm just going to dust that about a little bit. So the moral of the story is, it can happen to anybody. It does happen to anybody. They don't care about if you're famous or not. I don't know exactly what this person cares about, but they obviously have some sick, twisted, weird thing going on. It could be for anything. But in the end, it doesn't really matter, that part. What does matter is how we approach this. And if we start throwing a fit, saying, hey, we're tired of this, and actually dealing with this issue, more than just saying ignore it, YouTube will come up with filters to help stop it. And we as a society should deal with it head on, because maybe if people hear from lots of people that they really are sick. Now, I'm not suggesting you give 100 comments to somebody, because that's just going to feed it. Instead, say one thing, and if somebody else has said it, just let it go. Maybe like their comment, but don't feed this. And I think that that might help with it. It's the ugly side of social media we don't talk about. And we need to, because it's dangerous, flat out. People go from thinking something, to saying something, to writing something, and then doing something. And that is a known progression. And when people are trolling on the internet, they're this much closer to doing something violent. It's just the way our brains are hardwired. If you see it, you need to confront it. Tell a teacher if it's a school and it's somebody you actually know. Deal with it. I hope people actually start doing this. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!